Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday, Memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Be my protector, O God, a mighty stronghold to save me. For you are my rock, my stronghold. Lead me, guide me, for the sake of your name.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we who keep the memorial of the Holy Mother of God may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, faith is the realization of what is hoped for and evidence of things not seen. Because of it, the ancients were well attested. By faith, we understand that the universe was ordered by the Word of God, so that what is visible came into being through the invisible. By faith, Abel offered to God a sacrifice greater than Cain's. Through this, he was attested to be righteous, God bearing witness to his gifts, and through this, though dead, he still speaks. By faith, Enoch was taken up so that he should not see death, and he was found no more because God had taken him. Before he was taken up, he was attested to have pleased God. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For anyone who approaches God must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who seek him. By faith, Noah, warned about what was not yet seen, with reverence built an ark for the salvation of his household. Through this, he condemned the world and inherited the righteousness that comes through faith. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
Generation after generation praises your works and proclaims your might. They speak of the splendor of your glorious majesty and tell of your wondrous works.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. The heavens were opened, and the voice of the Father thundered. This is my beloved Son. Listen to him. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice. This is my beloved Son. Listen to him. Suddenly, looking around, the disciples no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone except the Son of Man, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. Then they asked him, "Why do the scribes say that Elijah must come down first?" He told them, "Elijah will indeed come down first and restore all things. Yet how is it written regarding the Son of Man that he must suffer greatly and be treated with contempt? But I tell you that Elijah has come, and they did to him whatever they pleased, as it is written of him." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Kagaya nga ng sinasabi natin, di ba, simula nung Webes, no? Sabi natin na yung ebanghelyo ng Webes, Biyernes hanggang ngayon Sabado, ay unti-unti lumilinaw, di ba, ang pagkatao ng Panginoon bilang tagapagligtas, bilang Mesiyas, no? So it's now, we now look at this, no? Because as we said last Thursday, that the three Gospels, no, leading to today, gives us greater and greater clarity that Jesus is the Messiah. And of course, in the Transfiguration, you have that the definitive assurance that He is the Messiah. No? Siguro ito yung ating masasabi natin, tema ng ating pagdinilay, di ba? Itong nakaraan tatlong araw. So what can we reflect on in this Transfiguration? No? Number one, this Transfiguration is an affirmation to the disciples. It is now assuring the disciples, no, because of the coming cross and resurrection, that Jesus is the Messiah. But it is also an affirmation to Christ, no, as we will reflect on later. Siguro yung unang punto na yan, na ito ay isang pagsisigurado, parang sinasabi ng Diyos sa mga disipulo ng Panginoon at kay Kristo mismo na nasa tamang landas kayo. Ginagawa niyo yung tama, no? And then the second point for our reflection is that it also gives us the meaning of the cross and resurrection. No? It gives us, as the spiritual meaning of the cross and resurrection. No? And then the third and last point is that beautiful line that the Father now tells the disciples, "Listen to Him." So, siguro ito yung pangalawa at pangatlong punto. No? Na sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, pinapakita yung kahulugan, ano? Na ang pagiging Mesiyas ng Panginoon, ang kahulugan ng krus at muling pagkabuhay. At yung pangatlong punto nga ay yung sinabi ng Diyos Ama na pakinggan niyo ang aking anak. So let us reflect on these three points. No? Now when you take a look at the Transfiguration, of course it assures Peter, James, and John, no, that Christ is the Messiah as He is shown in His glory. It prefigures the resurrection, yes, no? But also it gives them an assurance that, no, despite the cross, that the final word will be the glory of Christ. No? So that was the affirmation. But it was also an affirmation for Christ, no? Because as we saw in the Transfiguration, who appeared with Christ? Moses and Elijah. Remember, these are the two great traditions of the chosen people, the law and the prophets. No? And therefore, it is also affirming that Jesus is there is the continuity in Jesus of the law and the prophets, that it is the fulfillment now of the plan of salvation. No? So even to Christ, it was an affirmation. The Father telling Christ, you are doing well, you are on the right track. And it's very important because we all also look for our affirmation. As disciples of Christ, as followers of Christ, we do look for moments of affirmation, that we have made the right choices, that we are on the right path. And perhaps it will be good to look and to reflect on ourselves. What were those moments of affirmation? In the same way that the disciples and the Lord Himself was given that affirmation in the Transfiguration in today's Gospel. Siguro yun yung unang punto. Mahalaga rin na makita natin na kumbaga ay merong pagpapatunay ang Diyos na tama yung daan na tinatahak natin. Sa kagaya nga ng kanyang pagpapatunay sa Panginoon na tama ang iyong ginagawa. Dahil ikaw ang pagpapatuloy ng tradisyon ng propeta na si Elijah at tradisyon ng batas, no? Dalawang mahalagang tradisyon sa mga Hudyo nung araw, no? Nung sa Old Testament. Kaya ang Panginoon ang pagpapatuloy niyo. Kahit sa Panginoon, ito isang pagpapatunay na tama ang iyong tinahak na landas. At para rin sa mga disipulo, no, pinakita ng Diyos na tama ang ito ang Mesiyas, no. And then the second point is the entire meaning of the cross and resurrection. I always like that line, no? This is my beloved Son. Of course, in the original beatific vision in the baptism, it says, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. That is actually the cross and resurrection. Because on the cross, we see Christ, why Christ is the beloved Son, because of loving obedience. And the Father now will raise him up, give him the glory that was his from the beginning, and that is the how God, that is the resurrection. And for us, that is the assurance, no? That's why the Father says, no, listen to him. And it is really living the pattern of the cross and resurrection in our lives, becoming the beloved sons and daughters of the Father, and the Father being pleased with how we live our lives in the day-to-day. Siguro yung pangalawang punto ng pagninilay, na makita natin na ito ang kahulugan, ano, ng krus at muling pagkabuhay. Na sinabi ng Ama, ito ang pinakamamahal kong anak. Dahil sa krus, dahil sa kanyang mapagmahal na talima, pinakita ng Panginoon kung bakit siya yung pinakamamahal na anak ng Ama. At dahil nga sa kanyang mapagmahal na pagtalima, siya ay muling binuhay ng Panginoon, ng Diyos Ama, no? Binigyan siya ng muling pagkabuhay. At yan yung pagpapatunay kung gaano nagagalak ang Diyos Ama sa pag-aalay ng Panginoon ng kanyang buhay at sakripisyo. So this defines now, no, the cross and the resurrection. The beloved Son in whom the Father is well pleased. That's why we are asked to live out that pattern of the cross and resurrection in our lives. And then the third and final point is listen to Him. Again, we go back to one of the themes that we've been reflecting on the last 3 days, discipleship. Remember, in the Gospels, loving obedience is really the best expression of love for God. To be lovingly obedient to the will of the Father. And that's why the Father tells us to listen to Christ, because the Lord has showed the perfect love, because His loving obedience was perfect all the way to the cross. Siguro hilingin din natin to, na kagaya ng Panginoon, sabi ng Ama, pakinggan natin siya. At ang dapat natin pakinggan ay kung paano yung kanyang mapagmahal na pagtalima hanggang sa krus. Yun ang pag-aalay ng kanyang sarili. So today, let us reflect on this, really, no, the affirmation of what it means to be a disciple of Christ. And let us pray through the intercession of our Blessed Mother that we may be able to be given the graces to be disciples of Christ. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. When our Redeemer was transfigured with her, before Peter, James, and John on the mountain, they saw the glory of God. Let us seek God's favor in our prayers.
That the leaders of the church, through their preaching and guidance, may lead us to the glory of our heavenly home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the transfiguration of Jesus may make us aware of God's constant presence and glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may aspire to be in the company of God with Mary and the saints in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we honor the memory of the Mother of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of this sacrifice may, by your grace, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, you conceive your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer the litany of gratitude after the COVID pandemic.
Let us approach the Lord who makes all things new for all the blessings and graces we received during the COVID pandemic. After every petition, let us say together, thanks be to God. For reminding us of the fragility of life, shielding us when no one else dared to shelter us, and opening our minds to what is really essential, let us thank the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For allowing us to connect with one another with faith and love, despite the isolation that sickness had imposed on us, let us thank the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the heroic kindness of those who provided us with scientific, social, and spiritual help when doing so was both risky and life-threatening for them, let us thank the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the gift of newly discovered medicines and vaccines to combat the virus and the wonder of natural immunity, let us thank the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the gift of assuring presence when we were anxious and distressed, depressed and lonely, and impatient during the pandemic, let us thank the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Loving God, no thought of ours is unknown to you. No tear we shed is unimportant to you. No joy we celebrate is alien to you. You entered our world of sickness, suffering, and death, and you know the fears we face. Accept our thanksgiving for your provident love during the COVID pandemic. As you wept at the death of Lazarus, breathe the breath of life everlasting on all those who died from the coronavirus. You have turned our fears into joy, and for this we thank and praise you. To you be glory now and forever. Amen. Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. And again, please join us for Journeys of Hope and also for Proyecto Pilipino. Thank you very much. Have a good weekend.
in 2022, we received more than 60 million pesos worth of donations from you. Hindi po matatawaran ang tulong at suporta na inyong ibinigay upang tayo sa Caritas Philippines ay makapagbahagi din ng tulong sa mga pamilyang nasalanta ng bagyo, iginupo ng lindol, mga nasadlak sa baha at patuloy na nahihirapan dahil sa COVID-19 pandemic. We also utilized your donations to send children to school, feed families, provide livelihoods and food security, advocate for justice, help in peace building, and protect our environment better. Tunay ngang kapag patuloy ang ating pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi, at pag-aalay kapwa, mas maraming Pilipino ang gumagaan ang buhay.
Tandaan po natin, sa pag-aalay kapwa, may pag-asa ang bagong taon.